weird day today because it's a regular work day, but I had the opportunity to go to the Evanescence and Muse concert tonight, and I definitely didn't anticipate going out, but I saw that they were free tickets, so I jumped at the chance, and my sister can go with me, so at least this is one concert where I'm not having to go alone because either no one else wants to go or it's just really short notice. And so I'm trying to get ready for that, putting some makeup on. I was like, I don't even know if I want to wear makeup for this. I just kind of want to, because I'm working tomorrow, so I don't want to be out too late. And then the less stuff that I have to do to get ready for bed when I get home, the better. So that's what I'm doing today. So very impromptu vlog that I didn't even know was happening a couple of hours ago. We're probably going to get ready to go here in within an hour, maybe a half hour, depending on what time she gets here, and then I'll drive us over to the venue, and hopefully it won't be terrible, and like traffic-wise and parking and everything. I'm gonna try and make the best of it because I've not had the greatest track record with concerts lately. Like, the Nightwish concert was definitely the highlight last year compared to the others that I'd gone to, and that's not because of the musical acts, it's because people don't know how to fucking act. Where I'm gonna be at is gonna be like the bougiest spot. We should be in like swivelly office chairs and have a little table in front. I was like, free tickets, whatever, we'll get the nosebleed seats. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I think that's supposed to be a bad thing. But these aren't that, apparently, because I was prepared for that. And they're apparently going to be really nice and have like drink service and shit. One thing I don't like about the venue at all is that they have a no bag policy, and luckily it's cold enough that I can just I have a jacket and a coat, and they both have zipper pockets, so I can just put stuff in there because I'm always like, oh, what if I need tissues, I know I need chapstick, wallet, phone, keys, you know, the usual stuff, but earplugs. So I'm gonna keep it light today, and I really like Muse, but I don't think that we're going to stay that late just because we do work the next day, and I'm hoping that Evanescence's set doesn't last or will end by like 10 o'clock, because that would be ideal. That's like my usual bedtime during the week, or I tried to make it my bedtime, and it doesn't always work out that way, but it's easier to go to bed at 10 or 11 at night when I'm home versus if I'm out, obviously. I'm actually kind of nervous. I so wasn't prepared for all of this. I'm like in front of my curtain right now, so it's like I'm being swallowed up by the darkness behind me, but I'll try and video what I can there. At some point, I want to make another vlog just updating what I've been up to lately, because I've had a couple of creative endeavors that I'd kind of like to show. I'm just kind of wasting time right now until my sister gets here. I need to change my actual clothes because I'm not wearing a thermal to the concert venue. I have another shirt I'm going to wear, but I will be endowed in the giant winter coat and then a fuzzy zip-up jacket with zip-up pockets, utilities. So that's it. I'm wasting time. Let's go to the next section of the video.
Thank you. honor to play with such incredible bands. You're not ready. You think you're ready, but you're not quite ready. That's cool, we got more songs.
Thank you.
Yeah.
dating profile picture?
No.
That's what I call them.
Like headshots?
Not just headshots.
Dating profile. Those that you're fun and sassy. Cultured.
Yeah, you know what?
Keep it recording. Hi, this is my first Tinder account.
Wait.
Is that good?
Sexy.
Walk over the bridge. Then in 350 feet,
where to go. Take go the stairs. Over the bridge. I'm like, don't tell me what to do.
He's talking to us. The arena district.
Get some buka shots.
Buka.
You could have been though.
Oh. I didn't know what you meant by buka shots. It's so pretty here. I like those kinds of lights.
Oh, yeah, we did.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah, remember the train?
I impressed myself.
With all the coal?
I remember.
I mean, I had a map pulled up. You're impressed with yourself?
I know, because I said that 8 feet go over the bridge. But all I heard was go over the bridge.
Look, it's even a full moon tonight. I had enough juniper. Look, it's bothers. Oh, I was recording already.
Oh my gosh.
Hold on, it's recording.
Which background do you want?
You say that, like,
I didn't know.
Look at the towers. You can hardly see them with the lights, but look at the towers. TV tower. TV. I'm back home from the concert now, and I feel very invigorated. I feel good. I feel like I definitely don't have to go to bed in about a half hour and wake up early the next day. I feel that good that it doesn't feel like I'm in my real life right now. That was awesome being able to see Evanescence live because I've been a fan of them for the better part of 20 years and just seeing a live show never panned out. And around the time that they released their self-titled album, I was starting to get out of them a bit, and I listened to The Bitter Truth, their newest album, when it came out, because I was like, well, you know, for old time's sake, I'll listen to it, and I really didn't touch it since, so I listened to it on the way home from work, and then finished it off when I was home, which is a good thing, because I was able to recognize some of the songs. And it was awesome because they played Imaginary, which I kind of wasn't expecting. I really liked that song. A couple from Fallen, Going Under, My Immortal, and Bring Me to Life. And then the band, they also played Lithium, another favorite of mine. And a couple from the self-titled album that I haven't listened to that album for years, so I don't remember the titles for them off the top of my head. The seats that we had were fucking incredible. I mean, you know, it was further away, but we were in like the section with like the swivelly chairs and the little table in front, and there's enough room that you're not like shoulder to shoulder with anybody. They all performed really, really well, so obviously, since I haven't seen them live before, I didn't know what the quality of sound would be for non-recorded performances, because obviously as a performer, you want to, when you know you're being recorded for like a DVD or whatever, you are probably going to put forth a lot more effort. So it's like, maybe for another show, maybe they won't put in as much effort, but like, everything was fucking solid. It was incredible. Since I started singing, it gives me a whole lot different of a perspective on vocals, and especially live vocals. Oh, and the opener, the first opener, was also really, really good. It was, fuck, I'll put the name on the screen, something like okay, like A-OK something. We were listening to them as we were coming in and listened to a couple more songs as we found our seats. They're really good too. The vocalist is fucking incredible. We didn't end up sticking around for Muse, and in fact they're probably playing right now, and I like Muse, but it's already like past 9 o'clock and I need to start winding down. It was a really beautiful night, both the concert and the weather. It's a clear night. I think it's a full moon. It looks like a full moon. It's very bright, very clear outside. I'm glad my sister was able to go too, because I would have gone by myself and I was prepared to do so, but there were two tickets available and they asked me if I would like the other one, and I was like, okay, I think my sister would respond relatively quickly because it was just such a last minute thing. And she's like, yeah, I'll tag along for the experience. She's not like huge on Evanescence and never was at any point like I was, but she still recognized a number of the songs, and you know, especially the pillar songs like Bring Me to Life and My Immortal. Now I will attempt to bring myself down and get ready for bed and do all the bedtime things and take my face off and just enjoy the feeling of being on cloud nine. And then I get to watch back the videos that I took. I'm so glad that I had a good concert experience, being that I was kind of further removed from the crowd. I mean, it was like a VIP, like, I spent $10 to go out there, and that was for parking. Incredible. So yeah, I guess it's true what they say. Sometimes it does pay to know people. Sometimes it pays to know people that can give you things to go do cool things for $0. And I'm glad that I had a really neat experience seeing Evanescence for the very first time. And it was hard to be like in the moment and being like, I'm really doing this right now. I'm really seeing Amy Lee in person. Like, oh, younger me is screaming, absolutely screaming. I'm sure more of this will soak in better tomorrow to be like, what the fuck? Because, you know, ever since I learned about this when I was at work, I was just kind of like, go, 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 finish my work day, come home, get ready, and then go. So I've not really had enough downtime to really soak in what has happened. Oh, and I'm so glad that I brought earplugs, because my hearing is absolutely fine. Because a lot of the disorientation that I feel after a concert is because of the ringing. And I figure, well, I should probably take care of my ears, because I abused the fuck out of them with shitty earphones when I was younger, probably listening to Evanescence. So I should do something nice for them and actually wear my earplugs when I go places. My arm is big time falling asleep. Speaking of things fallen, which was in my little thing here. I actually made a mixtape. I didn't title it yet because I didn't feel like it, but I actually made a mixtape for the first time in like 15 years. And I was like, how do I rip a CD again? Actually, no, it's called Burning. Is it Burning? Burning versus ripping. See, even the vocabulary of doing this kind of thing is completely out of my mind. I'm getting completely off track here. I need to go to sleep. So, good night.